Some of the items were jewelry, lipsticks, and clothing belonging to some of the missing women. Leopard print fox fur handcuffs, night vision goggles, and a gun with a dildo as a silencer were also found. DNA missing, matching both the missing women and Robert, was found on the items the police had found. As police searched the grounds, they found remains of some victims, such as skulls, human hands, and feet. DNA from 33 women, bloody clothing, and a jawbone and teeth belonging to the one victim. On February 22nd, Robert Pickton was arrested and charged with two counts of first-degree murder. Between April 2nd and September 20th, 15 more charges stacked on Robert's sentence. On May 26, 2005, 12 more charges were added, and by the time his trial began, the total number of first-degree murder charges were at 27. While in custody, Robert told an undercover officer posing as a fellow inmate that he had wanted to kill one more woman in order to bring his victim count up to an even 50. The video was used in Robert's trial, which began January 30, 2006. Forensic analysis proved difficult due to the bodies being left to decompose or be eaten by insects and pigs on the farm. On March 10, 2004, the government revealed that Robert may have ground up human flesh and mixed it with pork that he sold to the public. Another claim was that he fed the bodies directly to his pigs, but all these are just speculations. Because the case is still under investigation, exactly how he killed his victims in full detail is not known to the public. Robert had claimed that he had brought his victims to the farm, handcuffed them, raped them, killed them by strangling them, bled and gutted them, and finally rammed them through a wood chipper, feeding the remains to his pigs. After a number of appeals and a lengthy court process, even though he was charged with 27 women, he was only convicted for 6 of the women's murders. The additional charges were stayed by the Crown. In 2010, Robert Pickton was sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole for 25 years, which at the time was the longest sentence for murder under Canada law. It's a strange and crazy case that at moments sounds so unreal, like the plot of a movie, but it is, sadly. Thank you all so much for listening. If you have any recommendations, please feel free to contact me or make a comment. I'm on all social media, and they are all linked on the page. Please feel free to leave a like and rate and review if you enjoy the show. I'd love to hear from you guys as well as your thoughts on the case. Please be respectful to the parties involved, and until the next time, take care.